में रहा होगा पहले, अभी लेकिन और स्पेशल किचन के बारे में बोलिए कि कैसे भी हो जाएगा, सॉल्व हो जाएगा।
और किस में नहीं होगा बताओ, आई वांट टू नो दैट।
बस देखो कोई लीनिएशन हुआ नहीं किचन किचन कोई।
तो पता है फेल्डस्पार क्रिस्टल, कैन यू डू इट? फेल्डस्पार क्रिस्टल्स, देयर आर सम फेल्डस्पार क्रिस्टल्स इनसाइड अ रॉक। फेल्डस्पार हैज अ बासाल्ट पार्टी crystal length and it has a basalt parting, so they are 90 degree. There is no feature, you know, which does not have a 90 degree features to it. You just cannot find a feature. जैसे बोला ना ऐसी चीज नहीं है जहाँ भगवान नहीं है, वो dead हुआ living हुआ non living हुआ, everywhere God is there, you know. Similarly everywhere it is there. अब एक feature बताओ जिसमें 90 degree position नहीं है, सब में है। सो इट इज ओनली हैव टू सी इट, वेयर इज इट लाइक, कोई भी फीचर ऐसा नहीं है इसमें 90 डिग्री
तक और ट्रेन पर पेश पे उसमें लेकिन साइड था हमें इसका डिफॉर्मेशन हो गया, वो मतलब टेंट हो गया कि डिफॉर्म हो गया, लेकिन सीधे साइड फीचर है हमको देखना है किधर
तो स्टेपिंग डाउन फीचर आप याद है
जैसे,
वो भी नहीं है, खत्म हो गया, मतलब सब खत्म करके बस लेकिन साइड रह गया, वो भी तो खत्म हो गया। Everything will be over, you know, then why to find it? So it is you who have to find it out, you know. So like, you know, in the lab we are doing this exercise, right? You have to find out the original orientation of the bedding. So you have to find a trick, you have to find a method. That is what science means. If you say it is not there, then who will find it for you? You have to look for a feature, you know, which will provide a shear angle. But you should know the principle, what is shear angle. If you understood that, then things will be clear. I will draw it. Let us begin with the other super. Unless I draw, then you cannot understand also. Suppose you have a orbiculite. Orbiculite, you understand, na? Suppose you have a, what is that called? Zeolite. Amygdules, you know. We assume that they are all spherical features. Like suppose, I'll just show this picture to you. Let me find a new one. Already this has been drawn, huh? So let me copy paste it. So why I have drawn these things you can understand now. Now I am just copying this. Problem. let me draw a few lines, you know, like this, like this, like this. Are you able to see? Yeah? No problem, no? I am giving different color to it. So that things will be clear for that. Now, what I am doing, I am making an ellipse out of it. Then ellipse out of it. Why I am writing 125 and 80 now I need to understand. 125 like that? Okay, na? This is what I am doing. See this train ellipse. So how much train I have given? 125 by 80. Or 1.25 by 0.8. Or you can reverse it also, 0.8 by 1.25. That is the strain in this ellipse. So to follow this. Now, what I am doing, you see, let us take a line, you know. Colors are gone, you know. Okay? There. Are you able to see the colors?
Yes, sir.
Hey, suppose I ask you, what about this red line? Whether it has gone extension or contraction? Now you will be able to tell. You have to bring the circle and put it over it. That is the method. So, isko la ke approximately me la raha hu. So, what it has undergone? It has undergone contraction. What about the blue line? Blue line has undergone extension. So, this is negative elongation, red line negative elongation, root lambda is negative here or in decimal, and this is positive. Clear, na? Then if I ask you, has this red line gone rotational strain, that is your shear strain? So how will you know it? So you have to see a perpendicular line and see whether the angle is changed or not. That is the principle. So that I was doing how? So in that case, you should have drawn a tangent, you know. For red line, let me draw a tangent here. Similarly, blue line, suppose I will see for the blue line. Let me draw a tangent here. I want to test whether they have gone shear strain or not. This I am removing. I am bringing, copy pasting it. Paste. So then, this I will give. Understood, na? Now you see, you pull red line has undergone contraction. The blue line has undergone extension. What about the shear strain? You see this angle? See this angle? So angles are also changed. It's no more 90 degree. So what the difference is your shear angle. So with respect to that 90 degree line, you have to come. Understood, na? This is the thing. So now, suppose I do this exercise, you know. From here, I draw a perpendicular on this tangent. Perpendicular on this tangent. Similarly, another perpendicular on this tangent. This tangent ka upar aur ek perpendicular draw karta hu. This tangent ka. This tangent hai na idhar. Iska upar ek perpendicular draw karta hu and another perpendicular on this tangent. Are you able to understand what I did? So I will measure for this red line, you know, this angle. This perpendicular and the red line, that is your shear angle. Agree? Red line and this tangent, now they have 70 degree angle, suppose. So 90 minus 70 is the this thing. 90 minus 70, 20 degree is the shear. So what I am doing, I am drawing a perpendicular over it. and measuring this angle. So that will be 90 minus 70. Na? So if you draw a perpendicular on the tangent, the line between this perpendicular and the line is your shear angle. Suppose you get a amygdule or some orbiculi, rounded features in the field, you know. Very easy. Very easy. And you have some radial line, suppose, inside these things. Somebody asks how much shear strain has undergone along this line. Draw a tangent and draw a perpendicular. That angle is shear angle. So this, if I draw here, like this. This is what we are discussing yesterday. So this is the line, say P. You draw the tangent here and a perpendicular on this. Yahan se perpendicular draw karo. This is the normal shape. So this angle is psi. This angle is psi angle. So tan psi is your gamma. This line has undergone. ये बात समझा कि नहीं समझा बताओ. Final photograph of this boy. I am to rebuild his original position. I will apply your principle. I refuse to understand. I am seeing you in original and in deformed state. I will compare. With this knowledge, I will rebuild his history. वो कैसे था पहले? तो ये that is what I'm telling. So I know this. Let us begin with the known thing. This is a known thing. This is a red line and this is a tangent. But I mean, इसको laboratory में इसको deform कर रहा हूँ. Edit. Now I will deform it. So deform करने से क्या होगा? This will become like this. So this is the original. Original photograph. Now this is the final photograph. I have knowledge of its original state. I have knowledge. Now I am also having the knowledge of the final state. So then how to find out the shear angle along this line? So only I have to draw a right angle over it. It's a right angle draw. And this angle is the shear angle. Because I know this angle was 90 degree originally. Now that line has become here also tangent. So the 90 degree has changed to 70 degree. So 90 minus 70 is your shear angle. So tangent to the circle after deformation, the same thing remains as the tangent to ellipse also. So these are some of the clues, you know, you should look. Samjha ki nahi samjha? Now abhi suppose आपको फील्ड में यू गॉट ए सपोज ऐसा एक मिला आपको एमिग्डुल यू गॉट एन एमिग्डुल यू नो एमिग्डुल आपको मिला एंड इट हैज सम रेडियल लाइंस द एमिग्डुल हैज सम रेडियल लाइंस लाइक दिस यू नो सम रेडियल लाइंस लाइक दिस इन द फील्ड यू गॉट सो सपोज समबडी आस्क यू व्हाट इज द शियर स्ट्रेन अलोंग दिस लाइन हाउ विल डू इट हैव दिस एक्सपीरियंस नाउ विद यू Then you draw a tangent here, you draw a tangent here, draw a perpendicular from this place, center of this thing. Yeah, as perpendicular draw kar. So this line ke saath jo perpendicular hai, that angle is your shear angle. So this is how you are, you know, backtrack. Understand not that thing. A tangent to a circle remains tangent to the ellipse also. If same circle is deformed to an ellipse. Yeah, this is your information to you. So in that case, all the just a minute. So now if I ask you to find the shear strain along this red line, just draw a perpendicular on this tangent and measure this angle. This is the shear angle. Yeh yaad karne ka aapko. Theek hai na?
Sir, in the table we are getting two exposures where we are getting like pencil curves or setting curves. One is 70 degree with the origin of and somewhere else is 50 degree. Then for both, what will be the shear angle?
What you are asking? There is the horizontal surface.
No, there is a horizontal surface like fold hinge area.
Huh?
Anywhere in the fold hinge area. Fold hinge area.
Okay.
And we are getting slate cleavage or pencil cleavage. In one place it is 70 degree.
So this is just a minute. What he is asking? You are having a fold hinge area. Like this?
Yes.
So you have a slatty cleavage.
Yes,
so this cleavage is like this, isn't it?
Yes.
Like this. So what is the proportion? The reference to the horizontal.
We are getting 70 degree.
This is 70 degree. This is 70 degree is the deep.
Yes, sir.
This angle is 70 degree.
Okay. And somewhere else we are getting 50 degrees.
50 degrees.
Sir, so this side, some other exposure.
Okay, so here it is 50 degrees. Okay.
Sir, for both, what will be the shear angle?
What about this?
For both,
for both the things.
अब क्या क्या होगा?
ना ये जो cleavage है, was it the original feature? Now it has come to this position.
हाँ वही मतलब सर सेंटर से हमने कल बोला था 70 वाले को हम 19 माइनस 70 करके 30 ले ले रहे हैं पर 50 को ऐसा नहीं कर पा रहे तो कैसे क्या पता नहीं कि
ये जो लाइन आप देख रहा है प्लेन देख रहा है दिस प्लेन इज स्लेटी क्लीवेज वी आर टेलिंग स्लेटी क्लीवेज सो दिस स्लेटी क्लीवेज इज डेवलप्स नो ड्यूरिंग दिस फोल्डिंग फोल्डिंग के टाइम में डेवलप सो देन तो देयर इज नो रोटेशन सो बिकॉज़ दिस फोल्ड हैपेंड एंड दिस क्लीवेजेस आर डेवलप इसमें कुछ रोटेशन हुआ ही नहीं subsequent deformation took place. You have initially, there are two planes. I understand your question. Suppose you have two planes like this, 70 degree like B, another is 50 degree. Understood? Now, this has rotated, further rotated.
Sir, ये मान के बाद चलिए कि एक ही fold बैठे मतलब एक कहीं अराउंडिंग पाया दूसरा कहीं और तो अगर मैं सिर्फ इधर उधर क्या क्या कैसे निकालते हैं
नहीं आप सब इस just principle is this plane ka agar aapko shear strain nikalna okay it has original position now it has come to this position yahi hai na
yes
so you have to see a line
matlab sir in area mein wo pehle vertical hi hota hai na steady grip banta hai
ha that is what I am asking you know
ki agar wahan pe hame
what I was nahi what are you telling initially suppose there was a bed and you have some vertical fractures like this and now it is folded when it is folded So some of the planes are 70 degree here, some of the planes are 50 degree here. Like this we are telling.
मान लीजिए इतने में 30 ही मिला है जो लाइक मतलब 70 कैसे मिलेगा पूरा ये मतलब एंगल बदलता जा रहा है इंच पे जो वर्टिकल है फिर सर एक तरफ से डिफॉर्मेशन हुआ फोल्ड जो है आपका ये मतलब यू से अपराइट से ये थोड़ा सा रिकमेंड किया
ठीक है
अब मतलब कैसे क्या पता है कि
नाउ यू आर गेटिंग दीस प्लेन्स यू नो ऑफ डिफरेंट एंगल यही है ना यहाँ 70 डिग्री हो गया यहाँ वर्टिकल है यहाँ 50 डिग्री है दिस पोजीशन सो यू वांट टू नो हाउ मच शियर स्ट्रेन हैज टेकन प्लेस हियर हाउ मच शियर स्ट्रेन हैज टेकन प्लेस हियर हाउ मच शियर स्ट्रेन हैज टेकन प्लेस दिस इज व्हाट नाउ अभी सपोज कम टू दिस लाइन विद होम इट वाज मेकिंग 90 डिग्री एंगल ओरिजिनली बेडिंग प्लेन सो बेडिंग प्लेन यही था This was the bedding plane originally. देखो, this was making 90 degree angle. Originally, now what is the angle? Now it is 120 degree. You see this angle?
सर लेकिन इसके बाद अगर second case का deformation
है। अरे रुको थोड़ा। अभी देखो ना 90 degree change to 120 degree. So 30 degree is the side. Tan 30. This was the इधर कितना होगा? No change. 90 now also 90 no rotation in this case 50 degree understood 90 to 50 so 40 degree the rotation so just like looking at this thing you cannot know you have to think that it was initially perpendicular to this so that knowledge you will be having is a limestone ka andar there are lot of vertical cracks so now limestone is folded those cracks will be rotated So along a crack, how much shear strain has taken? So this works. Understood this point, na? Na, tell me.
Sir, उस side से measure किया, उस side से measure करते हैं तो 90
degree अब देखो यहाँ 90 degree था. कुछ और this line was 90 degree initial. 90 degree. Now it has become say 60 degree. So you are really sense of measurement. No problem. Because strain is a, there is no dimension. Na minus plus nahi na.
Angle will be changed in that case. 70 or 70 degree. You see the 70 degree.
See here what you are doing. Suppose you are measuring this angle 120 degree. So 120 minus 9. So how much will be this? See measure in the same sense. This is now 70. 90 minus 70. 20 degree. You can also measure this one. 110 minus 90. कोई difference नहीं आएगा. This absolute value is same. कुछ पूछना.
करते हैं तो बात हो रही थी उसके हिसाब से हम एक पर्टिकुलर सिस्टम लेते हैं, दोनों को डिफॉर्म करते हैं तो बी वाला एंगल जो बचता है वो मेरा स्टेम बन जाता है। अभी 120 आपने लिया तो पर्टिकुलर सिस्टम नहीं बनाया हमने, मेरे पास आप एक पर्टिकुलर बेडिंग प्लेन था तो उसी सर्फेस पर अगर मैं पर्टिकुलर बेडिंग प्लेन बनाता हूँ तो 70 के बगल में 90 वाला लाइन आएगा, तो 90 उसके बीच वहाँ से एक वर्टिकल बनाइए सर सर्फेस में, आप बेडिंग प्लेन तो सर आपका वही है ना कि आप पर्टिकुलर सिस्टम वही बनाइए तो उसके बीच का एंगल बोला शेयर वाला
Any line here or any plane you can measure this here plane if you know a perpendicular line. ठीक है
बड़ा सर यहाँ पे आंसर क्या होता है मतलब इधर वाले
इधर बात
आंसर क्या
है 120 minus 70 तो क्या जो 120 minus 90
तो
that
is 180 minus 110
ये वाला ये है ना आपको लाइन ऐसा आ गया ना दिस एंगल वाज 90 डिग्री ओरिजिनली ना हाउ मच इज द एंगल यू से इट इज 120 डिग्री नाउ
वी आर जस्ट अज्यूमिंग इट 120
हां आई एम जस्ट अज्यूमिंग इट इज 120
डिग्री क्वेश्चन ही आस्क्ड फॉर 70 डिग्री द डिफॉर्मेशन इन दैट
दिस वन
नो यू चोज दैट लाइन एज अ 70 डिग्री डिफॉर्मेशन
70 degree deformation means this angle is 70 degree.
Sir, horizontal to 70. Horizontal.
Oh, aisa.
Sir, niche wala
bata. Niche ek horizontal line ko jisme ye 70 degree.
Haan.
Koi baat nahi na ye 70 degree hai. Ye 90. Sir, total 160 hoga. Ye kitna angle abhi bacha hai 90 degree se minus ko. Yahi to principle is this. 70, 60, these are our arbitrary values, you know. अबे समझा ना प्रिंसिपल ठीक है थोड़ा क्लियर हुआ कोई भी एनी लाइन यू कैन मेजर दिस एंगल एंड द लॉन्गिट्यूडिनल नाउ व्हाट यू आर स्केलिंग यू नो आई जस्ट कम बैक टू दिस पिक्चर So I'm removing again this line. Sir. So what I'm doing, I'm bringing this thing. So now this ellipse has been divided into four zones. Zone of extension, zone of cutting. Samjha ki nahi samjha? Now you can mark the one line also. These are the one lines. One line also you can mark. Suppose somebody asks you, this one line is a line of no longitudinal strain. But it is shear strain. It is shear strain. Along this line there will be rotation. What about this axis, this principal axis? They are line of longitudinal strain, but no shear strain. These things you should remember. So, if you draw the circle over it, this one line, this is the line of no longitudinal strain but it has shear strain but this principal axis of the ellipse ye dono principal axis of the ellipse they are line of longitudinal strain longitudinal strain but no shear strain. इतना तो समझा ना. Now what I'm showing, you just see here. ठीक है. Now suppose I show you what picture. You remember that? कैसे? Suppose in a rock there is a bed like this. So you want to see na? You see this ellipse? There is a bed like this. It's a bed. And you are putting a strain this way. Strain this way means when it was not deformed, you had a circle. Now you put a pressing like this. So what will happen to this bed? क्या होगा? In which field it is lying? You see the ellipse? ये bed को लेके इसका अंदर डाल दो. That is what you have to do. Understood na? Suppose you, there is a bed like this and you are putting a strain this way. You are pressing from the top and producing an ellipse like this. What will happen to this bed? What type of structure it will produce? It will be stressed. It's a stretch. So this bed will produce buddings. Like this, you know. Suppose you have a rock, you can see now the board. Suppose you have a rock like this, and there is a very competent bed here. Competent bed. Competent bed means what? A quartz bed. So this is suppose micasis. Micasis, this is micasis, in which there is a quartz bed. Very hard, competent bed. And you are putting a strain like this. Suppose you have a circle here, that circle will become an ellipse now, this way. So these are the one lines. Are you able to see? Now this is the bed, you know. So what will happen to this bed? So this bed will fall here, na? In this train ellipse. You see, if you press it, the ellipse will be like this, you know. Circle will become an ellipse. So this bed will fall in this zone of stretching. So this bed will be stressed like this, you know. The bed will be stretched. As a result, this bed will form this type of structures. You know. If it is caught into small, small pieces, they will form moving. Good. So the reason for developing this budding is stretching, because this is falling in the stretching field. Understood this part? Similarly, if I ask you, suppose the bed is lying like this, suppose bed is like this, and you put a strain this way. So what will happen to that bed? You understand, na? What I'm telling? I'll remove this part. Suppose I'll draw the figure here. Your bed is like this. Now if you bring this onto this ellipse, so this will fall here. Bed will be like this. So what type of structure it will produce? It will produce, it will be certain, na? So told, the length will be less. Since this is a competent, you know, a quartz bed or very hard bed, this will not bulge. This will not bulge. This will develop this type of folds. So this will buckle. This will buckle and produce buckle folds. Produce folds. So why folds are producing here? Because this is falling or lying in the field of certainty. understood this part or not tell you. Very easy, you know. But suppose I tell you, I am removing this thing, yeah. Suppose I say there is a bed, inclined bed like this, you know. There is an inclined bed like this. What type of structure it will produce? Suppose there is an inclined bed like this. What type of structure it will produce? देखो कैसे कैसे करोगे आप टेक दिस बेड यू नो एंड पुट इट हियर यू नो ऐसे पुट करने सो व्हिच फील्ड इट इज लाइक सी शॉर्टनिंग फील्ड इट इज फॉलिंग इन द शॉर्टनिंग फील्ड सो एवरी पार्ट नो यू कैन जस्ट मेजर वेयर इट इज फॉलिंग सपोज इट इज फॉलिंग हियर यू नो इट मे फॉल हियर They are not along the axis. They are at an angle here or here, anywhere it can lie. But what type of structure it will produce, you can predict now. Suppose it is like this, you know. So which field it is lying now? This one. Probably along the red line. Red line, suppose. So this will produce fold. You don't understand this part. And suppose I give a bed like this, you know. Suppose like this. Thoda sa aisa. Like this. What type of structure it will produce? Boudins. You understand, na? Why there is fold, why there is boudin? Why there is here fold, why there is boudin there? The answer is, it is falling in the zone of certainty. The answer is, it is falling in the zone of stretch or extension. Could you follow this point, na? The point is, what is difference between this fold and other pudding, you know? One which was like this, it was for forming pudding. It is also forming pudding. Are you able to understand? Yes. See, if the bed is like this, this is also producing pudding. If bed is like this, this is also producing pudding. If bed is like this, it is producing fold. If bed is like this, it is producing fold. Understood? So what is the distinction between this fold and this fold? What is the distinction between this pudding and this pudding?
Rotation.
Because this line has no rotation. This line has no rotation. But this line, all these lines are having rotation. So what will develop? I'll show you one. So this fold, what will be rotate? It will be, I'll draw it, yeah? Otherwise you cannot understand. Then you just lift this one. Yeah, sir, na?
Upar, sir.
Off, na? Rescue you after. Light there. See how interesting are the structures. Suppose, let me draw it. This is the English circle. This is the So I am bringing this circle over it. So this is making this angle. So these are one line. So this is the zone of shortening. This is the zone of elongation. Understood? Now I am taking example. First example is, suppose the bed is like this. Next example, suppose bed is like this. Third example, suppose bed is like this. Fourth example, suppose bed is. These are four orientations of the bed. So I am asking what type of structure it will produce. So this will be parallel like this. This one. So this will produce pudding, you know. Yes, pudding. It will make. will make bullets. Now, what about this? This will form. It's a fold, right? Very symmetrical folds, you see. Axial plane in this, axial plane in this, axial plane in this. Symmetrical folds, symmetrical buddings. Symmetrical folds, symmetrical buddings. Now, what about this? This will also form folds. This will also form folds. Folders? Yeah. This will also form folds. But what type of structure it will produce? You see? This pudding you see, this pudding you see, this fold you see, this fold. Is it asymmetrical pudding and asymmetrical fold? Right down, I will explain.
Have the hard line be rotating left, clock right or anti rotating? Hard line was.
That means inclined better.
Between left side or right side from the second to the asymmetric,
the axial plane will be lower, the left.
Now,
the axial plane will be lower, the bone axial plane will be lower.
It's not a series, the plane has rotated towards left.
Yes, samjha ki nahi samjha? Abhi, this line was here. This line is here. This line. Now this line is in a certain infield, so it will produce fold. But this fold cannot be same as this fold. So this fold will be asymmetric. Asymmetrical fold, you know, several ways it can be drawn, you know. It has a meaning, I'll tell you. Then only you will understand. See, when Ace draw this, it's a time for now. Now, along this line, this line, there is a thana. Please try to understand. So, what happened? This line became like this. सपोज मैं यहाँ परपेंडिकुलर ड्रॉ करता इधर परपेंडिकुलर ड्रॉ करता वो किस तरह जाता
नीचे
हम देखा था नहीं तो फिर कैसे समझो गया मैं इसको देखा सपोज मैं एक यहाँ परपेंडिकुलर ड्रॉ करता ऐसा मैं इसको डिफॉर्म कर रहा हूँ आने लगा क्या
सर थर्ड केस में अगर सिंपल सीयर होता तो वैसा बनता ना थर्ड केस में अगर सिंपल सीयर होता तो वैसा बनता ना
विद द हार्ट कमिंग लाइक दैट ओनली वेट perpendicular to this to kaise kya ho raha hai us small line ko aap dekho dekh rahe hain small line ko kya ho raha
hai
kis tarah rotate kar raha hai dekh rahe hain na to the small line tha ye line wo you mod deta hai is it aise mod deta hai samjha ki nahi samjha तो ये लाइन में व्हेन द फोल्ड विल डेवलप तो सिमेट्रिकल होता तो सिमेट्री ऐसे ऐसे रहता ना ऑल ऑफ देम विल ऐसे मुड़ेगा ऐसे बिकॉज़ यू सी दिस लाइन तो वो सिमेट्रिकल फोल्ड होता तो ये सिमेट्री होता है सर नाउ दिस सिमेट्री ना विल बी डिस्टर्ब दे विल बेंड हो जाएगा ऐसा ऐसा कैन यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस प्लान So the symmetry will be like this.
What the emergence of the fault is in the What the emergence of the fault is in the each of each side. How do you...
Is there a mood again? Is there a mood again?
But the line will be like
that. The whole thing will rotate like that way. Whole entire assembly will go like this. Inside individual faults will be... Why? Because this will decide, you know. That is what is happening, na? You see, मैं क्या बोलता हूँ आपको? आप suppose ऐसा एक bed होता, ऐसे bed होता, ठीक है? तो सोचो bed ऐसे होता. So these are the perpendicular lines, na? ये face में perpendicular line है. Understood? ऐसा. So this is the perpendicular line. Now when you are rotating this line this way, ऐसे rotate करना है. What is happening to this? ऐसे होता है. ऐसे हो रहा है ना आप देखो. इसको ऐसे कर देता. So anything standing over it will turn. ऐसे. That is why this perpendicular line is also important. You know, in knowing which way it will rotate. So now you can draw the folds. Folds you can draw. ऐसा. Able to understand this point. Little difficult to know at this stage to remember everything. So here there will be asymmetric folds. Here the asymmetric folds will develop. Yes. The axial plane will tilt this side.
सर वर्जेंस का डिफाइन कर रहा है तो सीएल का सेम पता लग गया काम तो ये लाइन से मतलब परपेंडिकुलर लाइन इधर मूवमेंट कर रहा है तो सीएल में सीएल ऐसे ही होगा सर साफ ही रेडियल राइट परपेंडिकुलर को लिख क्या करते हैं तो ये लाइन इधर मूव कर रहा है वो लाइन उधर हां तो फिर सीएल को हम परपेंडिकुलर जहां मूव कर रहा है हम वो क्यों बोल रहे हैं कि वो सीएल डायरेक्शन ये लाइन इधर मूव कर रहा है वो क्यों नहीं बोल रहे
आप देखो मैं क्या बोला ना लाइट देना लाइट नहीं जस्ट गिव मी गिव मी लाइट इसको बंद कर दे ऊपर इसको ऑफ करना ऑफ ना
Thank you.
and I am drawing this angle. Yeah. Here. Here. So we are talking about this line. This line is an alignment rotor. Is alignment rotor. Now this line, what it is happening? This line is rotating this side. Huh? This line is rotating this side. Yes. Now aap to fold bana denge, is a fold ho gaya aapka. When you are developing folds, na, the fold become like this. The fold become like this. When you are shortening it, here also, the fold will become like this. Shortening it. Okay? Now, imagine your this envelope, this envelope. This is the fold envelope. This fold envelope will go like this, like this, like this. This side will rotate. But what about these limbs? Yes, so limb kidhar jayega? These limbs, this limb, this limb, jo hai na? They are standing at a high angle to it. So they will take the path of this right angle line. So ye bhi idhar rotate karega, ye idhar rotate karega. Everything will rotate this side. So, ऐसे था. This will rotate this way. ये थे इसे rotate करेगा. But this line will reflect at this side. ये reflect इस तरफ करेगा. ऐसे result है ना fold will become like. ऐसे हो this is rotating. But these are projecting ना from here. So they will take a turn this way. ठीक है? अभी टाइम है आपके पास? सिमिलरली टू टेक द केस ऑफ दिस बुडिंग्स, दिस बुडिंग केस होगा, बुडिंग्स आर लाइक दिस सिमेट्रिक, सो अलोंग दिस लाइन हाउ बुडिंग्स विल बिहेव, अलोंग दिस लाइन हाउ द बुडिंग्स विल बिहेव, ये लाइन पे हाउ द लाइंस विल बिहेव. Now, मैं आपको दिखाता हूँ. Let us draw a perpendicular line here. अच्छा डालना उसको. So this is the budding line. boudins would have been straight and they were symmetric, you know, they would have become like this. You see? So now, this rotation is taking place, na? You see? The perpendicular line. These lines will rotate this way. So individual puddings will become like this. I think that is a good idea. Rotation will take place. I think my drawing maybe is a little wrong there. You know. My drawing is a little error. Because you see, individual pudding will rotate like this. Yes. You see the line how it is rotating. You see the line how it is rotating. So the structure will rotate accordingly. So this will be a NSL on pudding. NSL on pudding. Or you may say it is a, what is that? Overlapping pudding.
Same perpendicular line on the left side.
Left side means?
Line.
Yeah, that part is still left, you know. So you mean to say here?
No. Same line.
Leading
and right on the left side of the line.
From
my left.
This way you mean to say?
Yeah. No. Good. So, enough.
Like this?
Undefined.
So here you see, this I have drawn like this. Understood, na? What you are telling? I should draw this side. This side. So same thing will happen, na? ठीक है हां देखो कैसे हो रहा है वो तो रोटेट है सर कैसे हो रहा है मोर वर्क लो भाई नॉट अंडरस्टूड आप देखो ये जो लाइन है ना दिस लाइन व्हिच वे इट रोटेटेड क्लॉकवाइज ना व्हिच वे दिस इज रोटेटेड Clockwise and anti-clockwise.
Clockwise.
Rotation is same, na? Why it will be different? Dubara batayenge, phir aap socho. Not that easy, you know, at one instance, you know, it is so easy. Similarly, puddings also. Which way the right angle line is moving, you know? Individual puddings will also rotate. But if you draw this side, tense of rotation will be same, na? ठीक है ये बंद करते हैं नेक्स्ट क्लास विल सी आई विल नॉट स्टॉप इट हियर यू नो सी विल कंटिन्यू दिस डिस्कशन बिकॉज़ द नेक्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ द लेक्चर विल लिटिल डिफिकल्ट मोर डिफिकल्ट यू नो